All eyes are on Elsa. Elsa has literally just been upgraded to a hurricane within the last 15 minutes. It just happened during the last advisory. The storm is about 200 miles away from Barbados right now. So on the left side of your screen is a live look at the conditions there from a traffic camera that's in Barbados. You can see the wind whipping those palm trees, the wet weather, the sign there on the left-hand side, the real estate sign, flapping in the wind. And Trent, I'm guessing it's only going to deteriorate there in the Barbados as this thing gets closer.
Yeah, Amy, you got to remember this is moving about 30 miles per hour. So now that storm is pretty much over the island and will eventually be through the Lesser Antilles in the next little bit. And then later on today into the Caribbean. And from that point on is when we start to watch it with a little more close eyes, because the interaction with Haiti and the Dominican Republic and also Cuba in the days ahead mean a world of a difference for what we could possibly expect here in Southwest Florida. Right now, that storm is about 1800 miles away as a crow flies. And you can see that this tropical system is pushing towards Barbados and will eventually bring some tropical storm, but not hurricane force conditions over the next few hours there for parts of the islands. Breaking at 7:45, this hurricane now has winds of 75 miles per hour, and the pressure is now below 1,000 millibars at 995. The movement is west-northwest at 28 miles per hour. That forward speed is extremely fast for a tropical system. And as we look at the forecast track here, right now you see that icon showing a category one storm. The rest of this forecast track is now outdated a bit because the National Hurricane Center was forecasting this to be a tropical storm throughout its entire life cycle, but very close with those winds of 70 miles per hour. With that in place, they issued a hurricane watch for the southern parts of Haiti and the Dominican Republic earlier today. The difference of 5 miles per hour doesn't mean very much when you're talking about a tropical system as far as impacts, but for Southwest Florida, it's simply way too early to tell what, if any, type of impacts we'll see. And I say what, if any, because the models are diverging greatly at about 4 to 5 days. That interaction with Cuba, some of the models have a dissipating system. Some of them keep it south, have a Category 3 hurricane, and as far as the track, some have it over the Bahamas, others have it over the Yucatan Channel. So what the National Hurricane Center has done, they've taken that blend, mm-hmm. and they're not going back and forth with the windshield wiper effect, and they keep it right now over Southwest Florida. But it's simply impossible to tell right now what we're going to see next Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday.
So it's a wait and watch and learn.
Yeah, which is frustrating over holiday weekend, because a lot of people want to make plans, go relax, and enjoy. So we're all in the same boat, and as soon as we start to know more here over the weekend, of course, we'll bring that to you.